Hey friends, Elizabeth here from Plant Based Bride, back again with another video. And today I'm setting up my husband's bullet journal for May with a coffee theme. I did a coffee theme way back, years and years ago. I will link the video in the description box so you can watch it if you're curious. But I haven't done another one in a long time, and when my husband mentioned it as a possible theme, my mind started to go wild with ideas. There's so many different ways to do a coffee theme, but I really wanted to do it in a different way than how I did it last time. So I decided to focus on creating coffee rings and splotches, as if my husband just kept putting coffees down on his bullet journal in an artistic manner. And for the authenticity of it all, I decided to use real coffee to create this theme. Now, I had some trials and tribulations brewing dark enough coffee for it to really show up the color I wanted. I actually brewed 2 pots of coffee, which were not dark enough for my needs. I then made a really dark espresso, which was closer, and ended up having to use a little bit of Winsor & Newton Designer's Gouache in Sepia, which is a dark brown, to mix in with my espresso just to darken up some of those rings and splotches. Creating this theme is super simple, and it's another one kind of like my May plan with me, which was an abstract theme, where you can just kind of be free, and the more mistakes or messiness just add to the whole vibe. So this was a really fun one to do. I ended up using a small glass for the larger circles and a mason jar with a smaller mouth for some smaller circles. And I also used a paintbrush to strategically darken certain areas and to add splotches. Now, my husband's bullet journal is one of the Archer and Olive notebooks that I designed as part of my collaboration. They were limited edition, but it has the same paper as all Archer and Olive notebooks, which is 160 GSM. And 160 GSM paper, and this particular paper from Archer and Olive, handles water really well, but it's still not watercolor paper. So I will say, if you're recreating this theme in this same way, I would recommend putting paper towel behind the page that you are adding your rings to and your drops to, so that if anything leaks through the page, it will hopefully be absorbed by the paper towel and not leak through to the next page. I also recommend skipping a page in between so you can glue your pages together to prevent any ghosting or bleeding on your pages and to minimize any warping. There wasn't a huge amount of bleed through because I did make sure to shake off as much of the coffee as possible before putting down the coffee ring, but there still was a little bit. This is quite a bit of liquid being put directly on the page, more than I would typically recommend for a non-watercolor paper. So just keep that in mind. I just skipped a page in between each spread and glued those pages together. As for the lettering, I decided to go with this font, which is sort of bubbly and kind of reminded me of an old-timey coffee shop logo or sign. And I wanted to add a quote to the left page here. And I started looking up quotes about coffee, but quickly realized that there was really only one option, which was, "There's coffee in that nebula." Which reminds me that I have actually done another coffee-adjacent theme. It was a "There's coffee in that nebula" theme, which is very specific. That's a quote from Star Trek Voyager, spoken by Captain Janeway, our favorite coffee-obsessed Starfleet captain. And I did a whole theme that was coffee cups with nebulas coming out of them and the like. So I'll link that down below as well if you want to check it out. But this is one of my favorite Star Trek quotes of all time. Janeway's obsession with coffee is iconic. I have a coffee mug inspired by Janeway and her love of coffee. It's a whole vibe, and since my husband and I are big Trekkies and we always watch Star Trek together, I felt this was necessary. Once I had my lettering in, I added some more splotches here and there just to fill out the areas that felt a little empty, add a little bit of emphasis. And once that coffee had dried, I flipped the page to start working on the calendar. My husband prefers a two-page calendar, so that's what I do for him. He's quite busy and he likes to be able to write down every event that's happening, every show, every meeting. So the priority is having a nice big practical calendar, and then I'm just adding some coffee rings and splotches to sort of the outer edges to keep up the theme. While I work on setting up this calendar, since it's very straightforward, I'm going to share some coffee facts with all of you. Coffee dates back all the way to 800 AD. Legend has it that 9th century goat herders noticed the effect caffeine had on their goats, who appeared to dance after eating the fruit of the coffea plant. A local monk then made a drink with the produce and found that it kept him awake at night. Thus, the original cup of coffee was born. Coffee beans are technically seeds. They're the pits of cherry-like berries found on the flowering shrubs, but we call them beans because they look like beans. Groundbreaking. Another fun fact, you can actually eat coffee cherries, which now is going on my bucket list. Apparently, you can also ferment the pulp of these berries to make a wine-like drink. There are two main types of coffee, Arabica and Robusta. Arabica is the more popular species because while Robusta contains more caffeine, it tends to taste slightly more bitter. Brazil grows the most coffee in the world, producing about a third of the world's supply, twice as much as second place Vietnam. You can actually overdose on coffee. If you drink around 30 cups of coffee in a very short period of time, you would potentially get a lethal dose of caffeine. There have been attempts to ban coffee throughout the ages. Back in 1511, leaders in Mecca believed it stimulated radical thinking and outlawed the drink. Some 16th century Italian clergymen also tried to ban coffee because they believed it to be satanic. However, Pope Clement VII loved coffee so much that he lifted the ban and had coffee baptized in 1600. Even as recently as the 18th century, the Swedish government made both coffee and coffee paraphernalia, including cups and dishes, illegal for its supposed ties to rebellious sentiment. The last fact for today, coffee drinkers tend to live longer. Research has linked moderate consumption, about 3 to 4 cups a day, with a longer lifespan, plus a reduced risk of cardiovascular disease, type 2 diabetes, and Parkinson's, according to Harvard Health Publishing. And this is the fact that I will use personally to defend my caffeine addiction until the day I die, hopefully as a very old person, because I drink 3 to 4 cups of coffee a day. If you enjoyed today's coffee facts, leave a coffee-related emoji in the comments down below. Moving on to the final spread of this setup, the first page of my husband's notes pages. I feel like a broken record because I explain this in every video, just in case it's someone's first time watching one of my husband's bullet journal setups. But my husband tends to use more of a traditional daily log system as per the original bullet journal system. But he likes to think of them as just random notes throughout the day. So I start his notes pages, I make some sort of header that fits with the theme, and then he just uses as many pages as he needs throughout the month, throughout his work days, for personal things, drawing diagrams, making lists, whatever it is he needs. And that brings us to the end of this setup, so I'll do a little flip through for you. This was a super quick and easy theme to set up and lots of fun. There are so many options for how you can create rings and splotches. If you wanted to, you could get really creative and brew different strengths of coffee so you could have more color variation from light to dark. I had a lot of fun doing this theme, especially because I had to brew 2 pots of coffee and then make an espresso to have the right color coffee for this. I drank a lot of coffee on the day I was filming this video, which I am totally fine with, and because I had strewn about fresh coffee beans on the table for the aesthetic of it all, I was also smelling fresh coffee the whole time. Also, not complaining about that. If you missed my setup in my own bullet journal for May, I will have that video linked down below in the description box, so be sure to check it out. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you as always to my patrons for your support. If you at home want to join the squad, feel free. There's a link in the card and in the description box down below. And with that, I'm gonna get going. Thank you so, so much for watching this video, and I'll see you really soon in my next one. Bye, friends.